Oh, good morning. It is time to go home for Christmas. I just landed back here in LA about 36 hours ago, and now I am going to drive home to my parents. So I thought I would turn this week's Matt Chat into like a drive chat, shall we? All right, let's do this. Are you ready? We have about a 5.5 hour drive ahead of us. We are gonna drive all the way across the desert, and we're gonna pass some pretty interesting things. But first, we must Spotify. Oh my God, I am absolutely in love with Spotify. Oh look, here is a Christmas mix. Let's do this, right? Christina, what you giving me? Let's go. Coffee first, coffee first. So basically, leaving Los Angeles, I have to take the 91 to the 405 to the 110 to the 10 west. East. No, I'm going east, not west. So in LA, the freeways or the motorways or the highways, whatever you want to call them, the interstates, the reason they have a the in front of it, you say the 405 or the 110, was because back in the day before all of the freeways had numbers, it was called the Santa Monica Freeway or the Long Beach Highway. So when they then gave them the numbers, they kept the, where in England you have like the M1, you have A405, things like that. Pretty simple, right? Taking the 405 south to the 110 north to the 91 east to the 10 east. There you go. All right, so we are about an hour and 15 minutes or so outside of Los Angeles, and we are passing through Morongo. Just before you get to Palm Springs, there is one of California's largest wind farms, and there is thousands of the wind turbines, and I absolutely love renewable energy, as we all should, to help ease global warming. But as we pull into Palm Springs, if you're not aware of the history of Palm Springs, it was a huge mecca for the Hollywood A-listers back in like the 40s, the 50s, and the 60s. So you have the likes of Bob Hope, the Rat Pack, Marilyn Monroe, Sonny and Cher. They all had residence out here. Basically, the reason they chose Palm Springs to be their residence is the fact that it is 60 miles or so outside of Los Angeles proper. Why 60 miles? Because the Screen Actors Guild, which is a big, powerful entertainment union in Hollywood, has a precedence. So if you're within those 60 miles, you have to adhere to basically all the rules and regulations of the union. However, if you're outside those 60 miles, you don't. So that's why a lot of the Hollywood elite set up their homes or second homes in Palm Springs. Nowadays, it's not so much a mecca for the Hollywood elite, it is a mecca for the LGBTQ community. Don't know why, maybe because it's fabulous, but I absolutely love Palm Springs. It is super hot in the summertime and it is very temperate in the winter. It's just a really fun place to go that is an hour, hour and a half outside of LA. It's basically where the old people go to retire and where the gays go to play. What is that out there? I've been traveling this road for 15 years or so, and it wasn't until a couple of years ago that I was like, okay, I'm finally gonna Google what that is. Because every time I pass it, I'm like, what the hell is that? It's a big whoops. It's a big whoopsie. Back in the 50s and 60s, I can't remember the year, I think it was like 57, the US government decided that they wanted to put in a reservoir. Because Southern California has been and probably will always be in a drought. So they spent, I think it was something like $500 million. Keeping in mind, this is back in the 50s and the 60s, so it's probably, today's standards, over a billion. To put in all the infrastructure, to dig the hole, well, it's more than a hole, it's a huge crater back up over that mountain. To put in all the pipes, basically create this reservoir as well as all the drainage for it so that it can then drain into the valley. Well, they soon realized, after they spent the money and it was pretty much finished, that the rock that they dug into is too porous. It can't hold water. Yeah. Whoopsie. All right, well, 2 hours and 45 minutes later, we are crossing over into Arizona. We're gonna cross over the Colorado River, leaving California, and headed to Arizona. It's really interesting though, because as soon as you cross over the river, the land changes. I don't know why, but it does. It's very strange. And I will tell you another little fun fact when we get there, but I need to make a pit stop first to show you. So, like I said, I wanted to make a pit stop. These are the saguaro cactus. Cacti. This is a cactus, multiple or cacti. But what's really cool and what's really interesting is that these cactus, this is the only place in the world where they're found, in the Sonoran Desert, in the Arizona Desert. For some reason, this is the only spot on Earth that they grow. This is Dome Rock Road off the 10 freeway. I love it. I try and pull off every single time just because it's really one of the only places that's still natural, that's still wild, where you can see these guys up close and personal. You do have to be extra careful when you're out here because there are deadly scorpions, there's snakes, there are insects that you do not want to make friends with. And it's just freaking cool that this is the only place on the planet where they grow. They don't grow on the other side of the river into California. They only grow in Arizona. It's just pretty miraculous.
You don't want to get too up close and personal with these guys.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out.
All right, well, there you have it. 5.5 hours, actually about 6 with that one pit stop. But I've arrived at the family's house. I'm excited to see everybody. And as I park up, I just want to wish everybody a very, very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thanks for coming along with me. Mwah! Merry Christmas!